My name is Bill Frankhouser, and my wife and I own the Super 322 Drive-In. I've done this so often, it's just, you know, automatic. You kind of know its own little personality. So you're working with something, and, you know, you learn about it. It's a part of you, and it's a good friend. The sad thing is, these were probably going to be junked, because there's no more 35 millimeter film.
Tonight, Bill said, is the last night for film movies. It'll all be digital from this point on. So this is kind of a real historic event.
I can't wait to see how this works with the digital stuff.
I know our pockets are going to be a hell of a lot lighter.
Yes, I know.
We knew that digital projection was coming on. We've been watching this thing for almost 10 years, and we knew it was just around the corner. And right now, they're not making that many 35mm prints. That's why we're going to make the change. Over the years, I found a bunch of old previews, and I spliced them all together. I have about seven old reels of previews. Bring them out, dust them off, and then run them through, and that's probably going to be it. That's going to be the last time that those 35mm projectors will run.
How's the booth going to be different?
Well, you have to yank everything out and go right down to the bare walls and insulate it, drywall it, put a subfloor in. That's what our game plan is.
Just saying changing over to digital doesn't say everything.
No.
Just getting the equipment isn't the end of it.
Right.
And these people may like certain kinds of movies that the booker was not recommending, but when we got them, we had a very good turnout. Because we knew our people.
This is my second time. I was here when I was real little.
This place was packed that night. We had to park way in the back.
It's the drive-in experience. You have the freedom to sit in your car, sit out on your chairs and watch the movies.
We've had people come in here and they had like bubble machines. And it's a very, very, very neat type of atmosphere.
This year, it just came streaming right back. You want to start with that?
The old stuff? Start with that.
Okay, start with that.
Yeah, I forgot about that.
Need a flat lens.
Okay, two flat lenses coming right up.
I own the Midway Drive-In Theater in Mifflin Town. Opened the same year as this, 1950. Continuous 63 years. And the old projectors, there's absolutely nothing that I don't know how to work on or that I haven't worked on. And that's what we hate about the digital stuff. All the people that knew how to do stuff, you're not going to be allowed to. Any of the service will be done by a trained technician. Most of it will involve a laptop computer. Now I assume we can still clean them and change the light bulb. That's probably about the most we'll be allowed to do. Contact. We're ready, Bill.
Okay.
Lock your doors. Activate the dog. Send up the man.
We saw a demonstration of digital projection for a drive-in theater at Lockport, New York. I had 13 questions that I wanted to ask them, and they stalled. They stalled me, and I said, well, just let me ask one. How is this going to affect my bottom line? And they couldn't answer. We had talked about putting the second screen out back. Our bookers told us that the business has improved to the point where we probably could use a second screen. But I held off because of we kept hearing about prices on this digital. I mean, I have to come up with $100,000 to redo this, and is it going to increase my business? I don't know.
Guess what? You're great.
Yeah. Bad splice. I'm ready.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have often spoken humorously about my relatives and their invention.
Film comes in on shipping reels, what we call 20-minute reels, and I put three of them together, which gives us an hour reel, and one, two, and three on this side, four, and five, and six on the other side.
This one, Jack, is going to be perfect.
I can do that, baby.
Your last name,
I know. Now I got it.
It's scary.
First cue, you start the machine, which brings it up to speed. And the second cue, you actually do the changeover from one machine to the other.
Wait till the RPMs of the motor comes up, then open up the dowser, and on the second set, I hit the sound cue and the changeover cue all at the same time. If it's done correctly, you don't know the difference.
How'd the last changeover go, Bill?
Tough. Just before I made it, I thought about all the years that I put in the theater business. My dad wanted me to get into it. I didn't want to. I was more concerned with a kid hanging around the pool rooms and hanging around on the street corner. My dad and I had a nice little argument and he won. And that's where I'm at today.
Certainly it comes as no surprise to you that cowards of the CIA.
No, I do understand. And it feels like the heart of it's changing. Wonder if the energy of it will change once the digital's here. You know, because you get that feeling in your stomach when you're coming to the movies. Because you know what it's like when this place is full.
We look forward to the glitches. We look forward to the movies flipping and breaking and burning.
But it's either you do it or you close.
Yeah.
So we're forced into it. So it's not, believe me, it's not our doing.
What would it mean for you if the theater had to close?
That would be a tough one. I would look back and think of all the years that I've put into it. Would they be all in vain? I hope not. So it's going to be tough. I don't think it's going to really hit me until we start ripping everything out.
They own the law. They terrify your wife.
Take the deal and let's get the hell away from you.
He's a working man who's had enough.
Hey, Doc. You know who this is?
My wife and I were just damn determined to keep this drive in operation. We've had people tell us that if anybody pulls this off, we're the people to do it.
Last time.